sometimes it grabs.
That's too bad.
Oh, gosh.
It's okay.
Everyone. We want to just welcome you to Westminster Presbyterian Church this beautiful morning. If you're new or visiting, we do have some information in the pew in front of you and visitor cards, and we do have some welcome gifts out on the table in the narthex. And we're just excited today because we do have Tom Chasinski here from Minnesota Teen Challenge to share God's word with us. So we're really excited for that to happen. And a few announcements. Tom did tell me this morning that Minnesota Teen Challenge is having a Christmas concert on December 9th, but you do have to register. It is free, though. There are some postcards about it right outside on the table as you leave the sanctuary. So if you're interested, I know it's going to be great because we've had them come and sing for us before, and it will just be an amazing time. So we do want to let you know about that. Our Real Hope for the Hungry food packing event is this Wednesday. And this is for everyone here. You can come and help us pack some food. We've done this before. We'll have a pizza dinner at 6, and then we'll follow up with the food packing. And our chili cook-off is coming up November 7th. And I know a lot of you out there have some really great recipes. So if you want to share them, there is a sign-up in the fellowship hall so you can see if you can win that competition this year. Our food pantry, we do are accepting donations always. You can bring them into the church office, and we just like to keep that stocked, especially as we're going into the fall and winter months, just to keep food out there. And our Adventurers Club, that's our second to fifth grade ministry. We are having our event today, going out to the Red Barn Learning Farm to explore the pumpkin patch and some corn mazes and just have a great load of fun. So we encourage you to come to that. And our Candy Caravan outreach event is coming up, so we're really excited. If you want to donate some candy or if you want to volunteer and help pass out candy, there are signups for that as well in the fellowship hall. And I believe Gloria Onenson wants to say a quick word on our rummage sale and how it went. Well, thank you, Gloria. And yes, we are so blessed to have done well with our rummage sale. God has blessed it richly, and this will be used for ministry purposes. And so we are very blessed for that. And now let us get ready to worship our God in spirit and in truth. And will you rise as we sing our opening hymns? Come Away from Rush and Hurry, number 655. Confusions, fears, and pain. Leave them all. Let us pray. Gracious and holy God, we thank you for this day in which we can gather together to worship you and to praise you. God, we ask that you just help open our hearts and our minds to hear what you have to say to us today, to draw us closer to you, to build our relationship into loving you more and to serving you. We ask all this in your Son's name. Amen. You may be seated. Our New Testament lesson this morning comes from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 11, verses 28 through 30, and it can be found on page 12 of your New Testament Pew Bibles. And we hear words of Jesus here, comforting us and letting us know that we can rely on him for all things. And so we come to Matthew chapter 11, verses 28 to 30. Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. We praise God for his word this morning. Thank you. Well, we are indeed blessed to have Esther here with us this morning, and that was just absolutely lovely, and to just lead us in worship. And now it's that time in our service where we get to come before God with our joys and concerns, so you can turn to that part of your bulletin where we have our prayer and praise listed. We do have a couple of updates of people to add to our prayers this morning. First, for Nancy Lenz, who has been diagnosed with COVID. So we will be praying for her. The Jesus friend, Tim Hughes, he has a blood clot and a tumor on his brain and had surgery this morning, so we will continue to pray for him. As well as for Jim Jays, who is continuing to deal with some pain, and we would like to pray for him as well. But are there any other joys and concerns that we would like to share with our God this morning? Yes, Anne. Yes, we are indeed joyful with Millie. It was her birthday yesterday, and so just praise for her and all that she does for all of us. Yes, Gloria.
Just praise for all of the people who came to the rummage sale and were able to find treasures to help them through this challenging time that they face. And also, we've also, the two elementary classes who got some things from the rummage sale, Camille's class and Amber's class, the high school who benefited from all those notebooks. The teachers were excited to take them, and the VA who was able to come and take all the donations left over from the clothing and shoes.
Yes, so we are indeed... and Rachel's, okay, so our rummage sale just was a great benefit for many. There were lots of notebooks that went out to schools and other classrooms. The VA was able to take a lot of the clothes as well as Rachel's Hope. So a lot of ministries were blessed in this. Well, let us go now to our God in prayer. Holy and gracious Lord, we thank you for all that you do for us. We thank you that you desire a relationship with us and that you desire us to share with you all that is on our hearts, our joys and our concerns. And so we ask, God, that you hear us now in this time of silent meditation. And God, we thank you for hearing our prayers this morning. And today we'd like to lift up Minnesota Adult and Teen Challenge. God, we thank you for their ministry, and we ask that you continue to bless them and instill your Holy Spirit within them. We pray for Samantha Jays Langer, who's pregnant with twins and has low hemoglobin. God, we ask that you help to raise that and keep them all safe and healthy in your arms. We pray for our Real Hope for the Hungry Packing event that is upcoming. And God, we just ask that the people who are receiving these meals be blessed. We pray for Cameron Olson and his family for spiritual strength during hard times. We continue to pray for Pastor Mike and Colleen as they're on the fifth week of their sabbatical. We ask for continued renewal of spirit in them and just that you surround them in your peace and your comfort and your love. We pray for Nancy Lenz, who is dealing with COVID, God, and we ask that you help to heal her from this, help gain her strength back. We pray for Tim Hughes, who had a blood clot and tumor on his brain, and God, we hope that the surgery went well this morning. We ask that you continue to give him strength and to recover. We pray for Jim Jays, who is dealing with pain, God, and we ask that you help to relieve him from this burden. We pray for Millie, and just, God, we thank you for her birthday and that just all the wonderful things that she does. And God, we praise you for our rummage sale that many people were able to benefit from all these supplies. And God, we ask that you continue to bless all the things, all the ministries that were received by this. And God, we ask that you hear us now as we pray the prayer your Lord taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debt, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And although we do not officially pass around plates for an offering, we do still ask that you give of your time, of your talents. There are plates in back. And God, we just ask that anything that we give to you, you will use for your kingdom purposes. Amen.
Thank you.
turn to each other now and greet each other with signs of peace. And as you have a seat, I'd like to invite forward all the children to join me up here on the steps. I know you're out there. I've seen you. Come on up. All right. I see Micah coming. I see some people hiding. All right, how are you two doing this morning? Good. Well, I have something for you. So I'm gonna go get it, it's right here, and I need you to put out your hands. There you go, can you hold that for me? Can you hold that for me? Oh, okay, we have some more people coming. This is great. Have things for you to hold here? Do you think you can hold that, Benji? There you go. Do you want to hold that? I'll hold this one for you. All right. So do you think these are heavy?
Yeah.
A little bit, yeah. And we're holding it with two hands. What if I had to hold it like this? How long do you think I can hold it for?
Not that long.
Not that long. That is correct. I can probably hold it for a couple minutes. How long do you think you can hold it for like this? One hand, yep. How long can you hold it for?
10 seconds.
Okay, put it down. I don't want you to drop it on your head there. So these are heavy, right? And if we hold on to this for a long time, maybe with our arm outstretched, do you think I'd get really, really tired? Do you think people could hold it for like a day? Or a month? Or like yeah. It's probably gonna get really tiring. You can put them down for a second. I know, they're pretty heavy. So, these are representative of burdens we might carry. What are some burdens we might carry in life? Maybe like our worries, things we're worried about, if we're worried about not doing well on our test, if people don't like us at school. There are so many things we worry about. And do you think it's really hard to carry all those worries? Yeah, like bricks, they're gonna be really tiring on our souls. And that's what our passage was telling us when we read in Matthew today, because God told us to give all our burdens to him. And he's not just talking about these bricks, but he's talking about all our worries, all our fears, to just give them to him, and he's going to give us rest so that our arms can like not feel tired and so our souls don't feel tired. Do you think that's a good idea to give our worries to God?
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, well, can you pray with me? Dear God, we thank you so much for taking all our worries away from us and for letting us trust in you and for renewing our spirit and giving us rest. And all God's children said, Amen. All right, and you can go in the back for Sunshine Singers. Miss Anne's going to meet you back there. Yes, you can hand me those bricks. Thank you. Thank you. You guys are so strong. I think you can carry these a lot longer than you think. And now we'd like to invite up Tom Jasinski. He will be preaching for us this morning. He works at Minnesota Teen Challenge, and he just does great things. I know some of you have met him before, but we're just really blessed. So let's just give him a little round of applause for coming and preach for us today.
Westminster, good morning. Let's make sure I'm alive. Can everybody hear me okay? Good, good. Well, good morning. I gotta just open up with a great big thank you to you. Church, you have been so good to us at Minnesota Adult and Teen Challenge over the last several years that we've been knowing you. And thank you so much for the way that you're helping men and women find freedom from drugs and alcohol. Britt, that was just an amazing illustration. And I was just drawn into that because I think all of us, especially those with the burden of drug and alcohol addiction, feel so overwhelmed. And I want to just say thank you for the opportunity to be with you today to share from God's Word. Before I get into the message that I have for you, yesterday as I was mowing and bagging grass in the yard, God put a verse on my heart that I wanted to share with you, and it's not in your notes. It's from Exodus chapter 20, verse 3, or verse 2, excuse me. And in verse 2 of Exodus chapter 20, just a little reminder, this is as God led the nation of Israel out of Egypt, out of their slavery, out of their captivity, and was leading them into the promised land. And right before God gives them the Ten Commandments, he says this. This is Exodus chapter 20, verse 2. He says, I am the Lord your God who brought you out of Egypt, out of the land of slavery. Another version would say, I am the Lord your God who rescued you out of Egypt, out of the land of slavery. It's not just the clients at Teen Challenge that are carrying around bricks, right? That have that load, that burden. I think it's all of us. And I want to let you know that ever since Pastor Mike invited me to come and share about a month and a half ago, he told me about this date, I've been praying for you. And God has placed something on my heart that I've never shared, but I want to share with you today. And God has something amazing in store for us. As we carry those bricks, as we carry those burdens of life, I want to let you know that God is the same today as he was back in those days of leading the nation of Israel out of their slavery, to rescue them out of their captivity. Our Father God is our deliverer, he is our rescuer, and he is our redeemer. It has been put on my heart for me and for you that there are many in this season that we're going through with COVID and all of the challenges in life, that we face oppression, that we face depression, that we have hurts and pains and challenges. And I just wanted you to know that God is for you. As I've been praying for you and for me, if we are at the end of our rope, we are not at the end of our hope. And I just want to ask you, just don't answer this out loud, but I just want to ask you, are you at a point where the load is just getting too heavy? Have you gotten to a point where you just said, I've had enough. I am ready to be done with this. Perhaps there's a mountain in front of you that seems somewhat unconquerable. I want you to know that God is there and the battle belongs to the Lord. This morning, I'm going to share with you from 1 Kings chapter 19. I'm going to share with you from 1 Kings chapter 19, the first 8 verses. Before I get to that, I want to tell you what happens in the chapter before. In the chapter before, the prophet Elijah is confronting the nation, the Baal's prophets, and all of these false gods. And he is just at a point, like God is at a point, of being done with all of this worship of false gods. And so what he says is, why don't we build an altar? And why don't we see if your God or my God can set this thing on fire? So they build this altar, right? And Elijah encourages them to do everything they possibly can to see that altar be burned up. But they pray through the morning. They pray through the afternoon, and nothing is happening. And I love what it says in 1 Kings chapter 18, starting with the 27th verse. It says, Elijah started to taunt them and say, hey, why don't you shout louder? Surely your God, your false God, is a God. Perhaps he's deep in thought, or maybe he's busy, or perhaps he's traveling. Maybe he's just sleeping and must be awakened. Was there a false God, a real God? No. And that's why their altar did not go up on fire. So what Elijah did is built another fire. And he did everything to sabotage that altar from being burned up, didn't he? They dumped water all over it. That's a sure sign for a fire to go out. But surely, Elijah's God put that fire or that altar on fire. It says that he even burned up the water around it. That is so exciting because that is your God and that is my God. The same one that set that on fire can do something amazing in our hearts and in our lives. Well, then we get to 1 Kings chapter 19. And we see Queen Jezebel just found out that Elijah and his God had ruined all of her prophets. You see, she invested money in these prophets so they could tell her what she wanted to hear. But now she was upset. And let me just read to you what happened in 1 Kings chapter 19, verse 1. Now Ahab told Jezebel everything Elijah had done and how he had killed all the prophets with the sword. So Jezebel sent a messenger to Elijah to say, "May the gods deal with me, be it ever so severely, if by this time tomorrow I do not make your life like that of one of them." Verse 3. Elijah was afraid, and he ran for his life. When he came to Beersheba in Judah, he left his servant there, and while he himself went another day's journey into the wilderness, he came to a broom bush, sat under it, and prayed that he might die. "I've had enough, Lord," he said. "Take my life. I am no better than my ancestors." Then he lay down under the bush and fell asleep. All at once, an angel touched him and said, "Get up and eat." He looked around, and there by his head was some bread baked over hot coals and a jar of water. He ate and drank and then lay down again. The angel of the Lord came back a second time and touched him and said, "Get up and eat, for the journey ahead of you is too much for you." So he got up and ate and drank. Strengthened by that food, he traveled 40 days and 40 nights until he reached Horeb, the mountain of God. Friends, when we think of Old Testament heroes, we've got to think about Moses and Abraham and Isaac and Jacob, right? But I think you would agree with me that Elijah is another one of those heroes of the Old Testament. A man after God's own heart, right? He was committed. He was dedicated to the Lord. And God was there with him. Here was a man who didn't even pass away. He didn't even die. It says in following chapters that he was caught up in a whirlwind and taken to heaven. And later, as we'll see in the New Testament, Elijah, along with Moses, met with Jesus on the Mount of Transfiguration. A pretty significant hero, wouldn't you agree? And yet, we can learn from Elijah that when he faced challenges, when he faced threats, those heavy loads of the brick were on him, he was afraid. And he said, "I've had enough." If we can learn from Elijah, this man of God, this man that was so committed, that he can be afraid and he can have challenges and he can tap out and say, "I've had enough, God." Just maybe then, our God is there for us as well. The beautiful thing is, there was a miracle that was taking place here. And I think that's important for you and I today, friends. Because COVID or no COVID, life throws challenges at us, doesn't it? There can be many challenges that weigh us down and come on our lives. And what happens is we need to know that the Lord is there with us and for us. And he wants to share with you so deeply that he loves you and that he is present. Well, I think all of the miracles that Elijah did were awesome and amazing. What I found in my study of this scripture is it wasn't the miracles so much that he performed. It was the miracle of the relationship that he had with God. The miracle that he had a relationship with his Father, and it was committed, dedicated, and trusted. And friends, that's the miracle for you and I today as well. That same relationship, that same miracle is available to us that we can know God. Did Elijah feel afraid? Did he feel depressed and alone? Yes, and so will we. But in Elijah's time, like in our time, I love these two words, but God. But God showed up, and he was the deliverer. He was the rescuer out of the challenges, out of the incredible, incredible opposition that he faced. And what you'll read if you go further in this section of Scripture, it wasn't the loud, dramatic volcanoes and earthquakes. It was in that still, soft voice, that gentle whisper of the Lord. Friends, today I want to just communicate that God has a love for you. If anyone is questioning that, doubting that, wondering about that, The truth is, he loves you, and he has a work for you and for me. Instead of focusing on maybe the miracles, the dramatic signs, what if we were to focus on developing that relationship? And I think there are three things that are in this section of Scripture from 1 Kings that we can take away, friends. The first thing that God, through the angel, told Elijah, and he's telling us today, he said, get up. Get up. Don't just hang out underneath that bush. Don't just want to give up and say, I've had enough. I'm ready to die. He said, get up. Those were the words that Elijah needed to hear that day. And friends, I want to submit to you, I think those are the words that sometimes we need to hear those words as well. God wants to convey to each of us, I love you, I've never forgotten you, and I will never forsake you. He is sovereign, right? He knows all, he's in all, he sees all. He knows the name of every one of those bricks we're carrying, and he is there with us and for us. But what he needs is us to develop our relationship with him so we can trust his leading and trust the call that's on each of our lives. But in order to do that, we need to get up. We need to get up. I think COVID has shut us down. I think the challenges and the oppression of just the bricks of life have got us to the point where we say, I've had enough. I can't go on anymore. And I think there's some encouraging words here, friends. We need to get up. We need to take a stand for God, a God who is our deliverer, our rescuer, our redeemer, a God who loves us. We need to take a stand in the workplace, in our homes, in our community. Because if we don't stand for something, friends, we will fall for anything, won't we? He is our rescuer, our redeemer, and he's there for us if we get up. The second thing that I saw from 1 Kings that blessed me, and I hope will bless you too, is it says, get some nourishment and get some rest. Yes, we must get up, but he says, get rested and get nourished. What I thought was so exciting about that is we should never underestimate the power of a nap and a snack. Isn't that a good idea? Maybe this afternoon, maybe during the Viking game, you can have a little folding of the hands, a little shutting of the eye. Get a little Sabbath rest and build that into your life every day. But we must be nourished, right? I got hungry, Britt, when you talked about that chili cook-off, so I might be back for that. But we should never underestimate the power of a nap and a snack. But may I suggest to you that it's not just going to Tender Maid and getting lunch today or getting a nap. Really, I think what it is it's diving into the Word of God. The Word of God is the bread of life. The Word of God is that nourishment that we need to walk out the challenges that life has before us. Britt did such a great job illustrating this section of Scripture and these amazing words from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. He says, come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your soul. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. If it feels... instead of pointing it to you, let me tell you what I'm experiencing. I've experienced this load, this heaviness, and that's why this scripture meant so much to me. And I realize that if the load is too heavy, overburdened, then perhaps I'm not giving it to the Lord as much as I should. Today, if it feels heavy, maybe it's time to get up. But maybe it's also time to have some nourishment in God's Word and be rested in Him. I thought it was really interesting as I read this scripture, friends, that after this eating and this getting a rest, that there were 40 days where Elijah did not eat. He fasted for 40 days. Interesting, before Elijah fasted for 40 days, Moses did as well. After Elijah fasted, Jesus also fasted for 40 days. Isn't it interesting to note that both Moses and Elijah met with Jesus on the Mount of Transfiguration? What can happen when we take in the kind of nourishment that God would have for us? We need to get up. We need to get rested and nourished. But the third thing, friends, that I want to share with you is that I think we need to get strong. It says that when he obeyed the Lord, he was strengthened for the journey ahead. Instead of saying, I've had enough, I just can't take it anymore, maybe that's where we focus on the true miracle. And that is the relationship with Jesus and the relationship that we have with one another. What kind of miracles could the Lord perform in and through us if we keep going? If we keep going and instead of falling into the enemy's attack of saying, I've had enough, I'm done, I give up, just take my life. Just think of the miracles that could happen in the lives around us. But what kind of miracles could happen inside of you, could happen inside of me as we develop that relationship with Jesus Christ? And he says in Acts chapter 1, verse 8, and you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you. His mighty power to take that next mountain, that next challenge that's ahead of you as we listen to his still, soft voice. Isn't it wonderful to know that you and I have an advocate? When we are loaded down by the burdens and the challenges of life, when the weight seems too heavy and the mountain seems impassable, that we have an advocate there. In just a second, I'm going to ask the team to share a video with you. But I want to set up this video. I want to let you know that the actors that you're going to see in this video have gone someplace that they shouldn't. They've incurred some burdens and some challenges that they should have never, ever experienced. But when the enemy came to attack them and to devour them, their advocate showed up in a big way. Let's take a look at this incredibly spiritual clip.
Kitty, kitty, kitty.
That was it? Do it again.
Hey, come on, we're gonna shut up right now.
We're really sorry.
If you ever come near my son again.
Oh, this is your son?
Oh, yours?
Did you know that?
No, me? I didn't know. No, did you?
No, of course not.
No.
Ed?
Doodles.
Okay, maybe Lion King isn't that spiritual, okay? But I think that is a great illustration of what happens when we go places, end up in places that we shouldn't go. And the adversary, the enemy, comes after us. And we can roar all we want. But when God shows up and his roar takes place, that is when the victory comes. Friends, I want to let you know, if you're here today or watching online, if you've gotten to a point where you said, I've had enough, I tap out, I just want to be done, Elijah was there too. And God showed up in a big way and had him take an incredible mountain. There is a challenge, there is a miracle that God wants to do in each of our lives. And the great news is, friends, that the battle belongs to the Lord. But you and I need to stay in the battle. We need to get up, get rested, get nourished. And God is going to do something amazing. The question that's before each of us today is, will we let him? Will we let him be our advocate, take down our adversaries, and provide for us? I know the answer is, he will. Let's pray. Father God, thank you that you are here for us. We want to say thank you, Lord, for the gift of today. What a beautiful day October 9th is. Father God, help us to live this day to the fullest that you have for us. And Father, we thank you for the gift of yesterday, how it shows us that we can persevere and endure and get through, and you're there for us. And Father, we thank you for the gift of tomorrow, all of the potential, all of the future, all of the promise that it has for us. And that, Father God, when we are in the midst of our challenges, you can be our strength. Father, I pray a blessing over these mighty men and women of God from Westminster. I pray, Father God, that you would give them a vision for the mountain that you have for them and the guidance that you have for them as they surrender their lives to you. And just in closing, Lord, I just pray Philippians chapter 4, verses 4 through 7 over them. Rejoice in the Lord always, friends. I'll say it again, rejoice. Let your gentleness be evident to all, for the Lord is near. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Amen. Amen. Would you stand and join us for the closing hymn?
Now let us receive our benediction. May you go forth in the power, peace, and protection of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen.